Hi, it's Elsie. Welcome to my channel. I got asked to make a video on creating thumbnail for YouTube video. So with this video, I'm going to show you how to create YouTube thumbnail on your phone. To do this, you will need to download the app PixArt. I'm going to show you two different ways on how you can create your thumbnail. The first one is mainly using CapCut, and the second one is mainly using PixArt. Now let's get started. So you will open a new project on CapCut. Click on Stop Videos and select the transparent one. First, we are going to add a background to it. To do this, you can go to Canvas. You can click on Color to select a color that you like, or click on Background to import your own picture, or you select a background they have here. I'm going to select one to match the one I use with my video. I'm going to import a thumbnail that I made before because I want the thumbnail to have the same format. But you can skip this step. Then I'm going to adjust the opacity of it. This way I can still see where the text are and the frame that I use on there. Now I'm going to import a phone screenshot. Then adjust it to the place that I want. A lot of people ask me where I find the iPhone frame. You can get the iPhone frame by click on stickers. And you scroll all the way down to the frame category, which is next to the heart. And then you scroll down, and then there's the iPhone frame. Click on it and adjust it to the size that you want and the place that you want. You can see the corner of my screenshot, so I'm going to use the mask function to cover it. So I'm going to click on the screenshot, then click on mask, rectangle, then adjust it. You can adjust the corner to be round by moving this icon here. Now I'm going to import the CapCut tutorial part, which I have created the same one for all the thumbnail. So I'm going to click on sticker, then click on the picture icon, then select that. Then adjust it to match the size. I'm importing this as a sticker because if you import it as a picture, the photo frame will be on top of it. So usually the sticker will be on top of your video or overlay video. If you want them to be on top, you can import it as a sticker. Now let's add in the title text. So click on add text. I usually like to use all cap for my title. Then you can click on style to select the style that you want. And you can select the color that you want. You can also adjust the stroke of the outline, or even add a shadow to it if you want. There are other categories you can adjust it as well, so you can play around on how you like it. You can also select the format of the text. I'm going to import another picture that I want to use. I just want to have the icon. I'm going to remove the black background by using the splice function. Click on filter. Then I'm going to adjust the brightness of it to max so it's more obvious. And contrast to max as well. Then put it at a place that I like. I'm going to show you a trick on creating grading effect for the text. So I'm going to copy the text. You would make two copies of it, so that would be a total of three. Then you would click on the second one. Then click on animation. Then you would select the faked wipe, the first one, and adjust this to 1.5 seconds. And then you would click on the style and change it to a different color. Now you would click on the next one. Click on animation again. This time you would click on faked wipe, the second one, and adjust it to 1.5 as well. Then click on style for the third one and select another color. Then you can click on the first one, second one, third one. What it does is to make the last text to be on top, and then the second text will be on second, and then the first one that you click would be last. Then we would go back to the overlay track and remove the template one that we put in there. And now you would slide it to where you like the gradient effect. You can see there's red, orange, and yellow. And once you are happy of that, then you can screenshot it. Now you would go to PixArt. Then click on the plus icon. Go to all photos. Select the screenshot that we just made. Then click on tools, crop. Then you will scroll all the way down to the bottom. Click on YouTube and adjust it to the part where you want to be show as the thumbnail. You can always zoom in if you want. Once you are happy of it, then click on apply, and then you can click on save. Then you go to the video that you want to change the thumbnail, and then you just import the thumbnail. So that's how you can use CapCut to make the thumbnail that you want, and just use PixArt to crop out the size that you want for it. Now let me show you the second way on how you can mainly using PixArt to create a thumbnail. First, you want to take a screenshot of the video that you want to use. I want to use this part, so I'm going to take a screenshot of it. Then open PixArt. Select the screenshot that we just did. If you want to use the whole screen, you can just click on tools and crop out to the YouTube size that you want. But I just want to use the character part, so I'm going to click on cut out and then select the person. So it might not detect it, so you can always do your own. Then click on next. So the red highlight is the part it will keep, and everything else it would be removed. You can always click on preview to see what is being erased. So there's some part that's missing, so you can always zoom in and then use the restore function to put more on it. You can click on it and then you can adjust the size of the brush. Once you are happy with the cutout you want, then click on save. Then click on this icon to save the picture. Actually, there's another way that I prefer to use, which is using the website remove.bg. Then click on upload image. Select the picture that you want to remove background. And it would remove the background for you. I think it does a pretty decent job. So after you are done, you can click on download. And then you can just save the image. Now let's go back to PixArt. Then we will go down to color backgrounds. Select the transparent one. Go to fit. Select the ratio. YouTube. And then you can select a color for the background. Or you can click on background. There are different backgrounds that you can use. Image. If you find one that you are happy, then you can click on apply. Now add in the image that we just made. Add photo. Add in the image that we just removed the background. Then you can click on border and select the color that you like. Adjust it to how much you want. You can also add a shadow to it if you want. Once you're happy with the location, click on apply. Then you can click on text to add in the title. You can select the color that you like. You can add stroke to it. You can also select the font that you like. Once you're happy with it, then you can click on apply. You can add sticker to it if you want. Once you are happy with it, then you can click on apply and then save it. Now you have created a thumbnail using PixArt. So that's how you can use CapCut and PixArt to create thumbnail for YouTube video. I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you enjoyed the video, please consider like, subscribe, and comment down below to help boost the YouTube algorithm to help more people see my channel. As always, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.